In this video, I'll share some essential techniques for working with percentages in Excel that every data analyst, student, and professional must know. We will cover how to calculate percent of total, calculate percent change, increase or decrease number by a percentage, calculate original value after a percentage increase or decrease, how to calculate CAGR, and how to calculate percentiles. These are must-know skills for anyone working with data in Excel. If you like this video, please like it, share it, and subscribe to the channel. Let's begin. First, calculate percent of total. First, we'll see how to calculate the percentage of a total in Excel. This calculation shows how much a part contributes to the whole. We'll explore three different methods to calculate the percentage of a total, including Excel's latest function percentof. First method, using a formula. Write is equal to, select this cell. Divide by the sum of the entire range. You can either sum the range separately or within the formula. Press F4 to lock the range and enter. Double-click on this plus sign to copy the formula down. Finally, convert the result into a percentage format. Second method is using Quick Analysis Tool. Select the data range, click on the Quick Analysis Tool icon, then click on Totals. Click on this arrow and select the percentage of total option. Excel will automatically calculate the percentage of the total for each item. Third method is using Excel's latest function, percentof. Write is equal to percentof. Data subset will be this value, and for data all, select the entire range and press F4 to lock it. Press enter. No need to calculate sum. This method calculates the percentage directly without needing to sum the range separately. Next, let's learn how to calculate the percentage change between two numbers. This is useful for comparing values, like sales figures, from one month to the next. To calculate the percentage change, the formula is current month minus previous month divide by previous month. Or we can say, current month divide by previous month minus 1. To calculate the percentage change, we will select the cell of second month, because for the first month, we can't calculate the percentage change since there's no previous month's value to compare. Write is equal to, select current month divide by previous month minus 1 and press enter. Convert into percentage. And drag this formula down to apply it to the rest of the months. This will give you the percentage change from one month to the next across your dataset. Next, let's see how to increase or decrease a number by a percentage. Here, we have price of these 5 products, and there is remarks against each. For example, one price increases by 10%, another decreases by 15%, and so on. We need to calculate new price of the product. Now, let's calculate the new price of the product. First, let's write the percentage next to each product. For the first product, we need to increase the price by 10%. So write is equal to, select the price, multiply with percentage. To increase, we need to add the original price. And this gives us our new increased price. To simplify this formula, write is equal to, select this price, multiply by open parentheses, 1 plus select percentage. Close parentheses and press enter. This is the new price with the increase applied. For a decrease, simply replace the plus sign with a minus sign in the formula. One important thing to remember, if the percentages are formatted with a percentage sign, the formula works as shown. However, if the percentages are just numbers, like 20 instead of 20%, you'll need to add a percentage sign in the formula to convert the number into a percentage. And there you have it, your new price is calculated with the specified percentage increases or decreases. Next, how to calculate the original value when you only have the increased or decreased price. This is a useful technique if you need to figure out what the original price was before a percentage increase or decrease was applied. Imagine you have the current price of a product after a 15% increase. Or perhaps you have the price after a 10% discount. How do you find the original price? In this case, our price was increased by 15%. Right is equal to, now select the current price and divide it by open parentheses, 1 plus, percentage, close parentheses. And press enter. And here we have our original price of the product. This is discounted price, and we want to find original price. Select this cell, divide by, 1, minus, select this cell. And press enter. Now, let's move on to our next topic, is calculate the compound annual growth rate, CAGR, in Excel. CAGR means annual growth rate of value over a period of time. Here we have sales data of 5 products for 5 years. We want to find the CAGR of each product. Select this cell. Now right is equal to, open parentheses, select the ending value, divide by the starting value, close parentheses. Next, raise this to the power of 1, divided by the number of periods. Here, number of period will be 4. If you don't know the number of period, simply subtract end year with initial year. Next, subtract 1 to get the CAGR. Convert this into percentage. The CAGR value represents the annual growth rate of your investment over the specified period. For example, if the CAGR is 14.87%, it means the investment grew by an average of 14.87% per year, over 5 years. Next, let's see how to calculate percentile in Excel. We have a list of scores for 30 students, and we want to know the score that represents the 90th, 75th, and 50th percentile. What does this actually mean? A percentile tells you the value below which a certain percentage of data falls. For example, the 90th percentile means that 90% of the data is below this value. Let's see with an example. Right is equal to percentile. Initially there was a percentile function, but now we have 2 more versions, percentile inc and percentile x. Percentile inc is most commonly used. We will also use percentile inc here. Now open parentheses, select this range, press F4 to lock the range. Next for K, if we write 1 and press enter, it shows the maximum value in the range, that means all other score are below this score. Now, we want value for 90th percentile, so we will change here, 0.9, press enter. This formula will return the score, below which, 90% of the data falls, meaning only 10% of the scores are higher than this value. Next, similarly let's find for 75th percentile and 50th percentile. So, 75% students falls below this score, and 50% students fall below this score. Next, let's calculate the percentile rank for each student to see where they stand in the dataset. So here, write percent rank inc. Select the range. Press F4, select the score, and press enter. And drag the formula down. And here we have result of percentile rank of each student. The result will show you the percentile rank for each student. For example, if a student has a 100% rank, they have the highest score. If a student has a 90% rank, it means they scored better than 90% of the other students. That wraps up our exploration of key techniques for working with percentages in Excel. Whether you're calculating the percentage of a total, analyzing percentage changes, these skills are crucial for making informed decisions based on your data. Thanks for watching this video. Hope you found these methods helpful. Please give this video a thumbs up, share it with others, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. See you in the next video.